Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. In today's video I'll be showing you how to make your own safety box for troubleshooting faulty switch mode power supply and as well when you are making or testing your own transformers. Now the safety box which you will gonna make it will be very simple and as well very easy to use when you need it. As example, this is an ordinary incandescent 70 watts bulb. For those who are making transformers or modifying them as example by rewinding the secondary coil of a transformer to achieve different voltage, or another example it will be when you have a small SMPS or switch mode power supply and are you attempting to fix it. Quick disclaimer, by the way, everything which is showing on this video is just for those who are dealing fixing or making any type of SMPS or transformer and shall not be repeated by any means if you are not aware of the danger of 110 or 220 volts are coming with it, and shall not be remaked if you are not having the knowledge needed, so be aware. If you are still planning to make it, it will not be my responsibility for damaging of your goods and harm to yourself, so be aware. Now with that out of the way, you can proceed further with the build. First we need a bulb. This is a 70 watts incandescent bulb, which I was having for quite some time. Now it's important that the bulb has to be at least between 30 or 70 watts. The smaller the power of the bulb, the more limited will be our device connected to it. As example, a 70 watts bulb connected to a small SMPS, it will act as an inrush limiter, sort like a NTC or negative temperature coefficient. Will react when the main power is applied to it. Now you may say, for what you need another limiter in series with our existing one, which may be or not be, but usually most of the SMPS has one built in. The job of the lamp, apart from limiting the entire device, it will be acting as a safety lamp. If a problem occurs, example if you have a transformer or a small SMPS, the output has a leak or a short circuit, it will light up and signalate a problem with the device. Now for a SMPS, it will act a bit different because usually they have a short circuit built in. This is because the protection of the board will kick in by changing the off-on state of the transistor, or for short, the duty cycle. Now this was just a short explanation about the lamp, how it will act in the circuit. Onto the case now. This is a ATX PSU case which I was having lying around, and it will be perfect because of the size of it and as well it will be matching my workbench setup. For turning the safety box on or off, I will be using two simple switches, one with a single pole and the second with two pole. You may ask why we need two switches. Because the first switch it will be for powering the unit up through a fuse series with the rest of the unit, and the second switch, a dual pole switch, it will allow for bypassing the lamp in one way and for bypassing the lamp after the power supply of the transformer which is connected to it are properly working. This will ensure a second layer of protection because we can still let the device connected to the unit, and after with a flick of the switch we can test it normally like it was without the safety box. But keep in mind, the safety box is not isolated from the main. Now let's make the safety box. I start first by adding a simple voltmeter. This will be showing the main voltage, along it will provide an indication that the unit is on. And with the help of a trimmer and as well a handsaw, the hole was cut without much hassle. I know it doesn't look nice, but it's okay for me. Second, I start enlarging the hole for my dual pole switch using my Dremel and a sanding roll, and after I will be making a simple stand for my bulb socket by using an old spool of solder wire, and after drilling two holes with the drill through the entire spool down the spool, it is just for rising a bit the bulb holder from the bottom of the unit, and after the spool is bolted down to the unit we can finish the job by adding some zip ties and securing our bulb holder. Now we can start making the holes for our switch and as well for the fuse holder. For the external connector, I was thinking to go with this speaker connector which I was having, but in the end I choose to go with this kind of connector. They are like very similar like binding post, but they have a spring loaded button which will allow for easy connecting and disconnecting the device which is hooked up to the unit. And after that was done, I have taken the case and sprayed it with some grey primer, and after I followed that up with some black paint with a matte finish. This will look nice because it will match one of my power supply design color. Now after the case was done, we can start assembling the unit by first adding the switches, the fuse holder and the C13 connector, and as well the dual pole switch, the display and the two binding posts. Now it is very important that the two binding posts which are on the front of the case, they are properly isolated, and for that I recommend you to check with a multimeter and as well use some layer of heating tubings for strengthen the isolation between the case and the binding post screws. And after this we can add the light bulb and the safety box is done. For the first test, here I have a transformer which I have rewind the secondary coil to give me about 6 volts RMS, and as you can see, when we first power the unit up, the bulb will flash for a brief moment. This is due to the fact that at the beginning of every device it exists so-called inrush The current in the device will rush in, but our bulb will act as an inertia limiter, and in exchange it will flash for a brief moment. Now if I will be shorting the output of the transformer, we can see that the bulb will light up at full brightness. This will indicate that we have a short situation. Keep in mind that the transformer it is an induction load, so it uses reactive power, not like a SMP active power. Now let's try with a SMPS or switch mode power supply. At the beginning of powering the board we see the same reaction, and as well if the board was damaged, the light will stay on, dim or bit brighter. Now if I short the output of the SMPS, you can see that it's going straight in the protection and it will start to flicker on and off continuously, but the bulb it will never came on because this SMPS has a short protection built in. Here I have one without protection built in. So let's try it. After the power up, we can see that the output is about 12 volts. And by shorting the power supply output, we can see that the bulb is turning with a delay. So this power supply doesn't have a protection built in against short circuit. Now details about this project can be found in the video description. So here is coming the part where I have to say goodbye. Now this was a great project to make, and as all I hope you have learned something interesting today. I hope I will see you all in my next video. Until then, have a nice day and thank you very much for watching. See ya!